take a look at the picture on the screen. Over here, you will find that there are many loops over here which have been generated with the help of a single conductor. Now, this is a copper wire. Earlier, we have studied that how we can twist a copper wire in the shape of a circular loop, and if current flows through this loop, then a certain magnetic field is generated. Now, what if in place of a single loop, we have multiple loops, one after the other? This can be achieved if we continuously twist a conductor in the manner shown. The structure which we obtain is known as a solenoid. So when current flows through the solenoid, a definite magnetic field is generated. So let us see how we can find out the direction of the magnetic field around a solenoid when current flows through it. This simple experiment, in which we use a simple magnetic needle, demonstrates the direction in which magnetic field is pointed around the current carrying solenoid. As you can see, as the needle is placed at different points around the solenoid, the deflection of the needle changes. This indicates that the needle is pointing towards the direction in which the magnetic field lines are pointing. So now let us take a look at another video where we will be able to find out the pattern of the magnetic field lines. In this video, you will find that a solenoid has been considered, and the iron filings initially, when there is no current, are randomly placed. Now notice closely what happens when current starts flowing. As you can see at these parts, at the ends of the solenoid, the iron filings come close to one another and they form a definite pattern. You can see that the definite pattern is being pointed out in the video, and the iron filings at each of the holes has formed a definite pattern. And this pattern gives us the pattern in which the magnetic field is present around the current carrying solenoid. So we found out what the pattern of the magnetic field lines are and in which direction they are pointed. So now consider this picture. Let us say I have considered that current is entering from this direction and exiting from that direction. Now let us consider each of these faces separately. When I look at this particular face, I will find that current is flowing in this direction. Now what does this correspond to? If you look at it closely, then this resembles a clockwise rotation. Now if I resemble the clockwise rotation in this manner, I find that it is the letter S. So clearly this is the south pole, because if you recall from our previous discussion on a circular loop, when we have clockwise rotation of current, it implies the south pole. Similarly, if we consider the other face, we will find that current is leaving the face in this manner. So if I have to look at that face from this side, I will find that current is moving in the anti-clockwise direction. Now, what had we studied about anti-clockwise direction of current in a circular loop? We had found that if we consider the letter N and place two arrows at both ends, this indicates anti-clockwise direction. So this is the north pole of the solenoid. And as you can clearly see from the field lines, the magnetic field lines are leaving the north pole, traveling all the way outside the solenoid and entering at the south pole. And inside the solenoid, they are traveling from south to north. So what does a solenoid behave as? Doesn't this behavior of magnetic field lines seem familiar to you? That is right. This solenoid has field line configuration that is very similar to that of a bar magnet. So over here, we have a bar magnet, and over here we have a solenoid. So as you can see, the field lines, that is the magnetic field lines around a solenoid, have a similar direction and orientation as the magnetic field lines of the bar magnet, provided the north and south of the solenoid as well as the bar magnet are facing the same direction. So we have found out that when current is flowing through a solenoid, and if we look at the solenoid from the top, then this is the south pole because current is in the clockwise direction, and this is the north pole because current is in the anticlockwise direction. So this is how a current carrying solenoid resembles a bar magnet.